So today we are discussing OPAMP application and use of OPAMP as Schmidt trigger, which uses positive feedback. So far, whatever circuits we have analyzed with OPAMP had negative feedback. But this particular circuit, Schmidt trigger or regenerative comparator, uses positive feedback. Okay, so one thing from here you can remember, whenever we will talk about any regenerative device, that means your OPAMP will have positive feedback. Okay, so the comparators which you have seen in the previous lecture, if you just change the feedback and make it to positive, then you can get the circuit for Schmidt trigger. Okay, so Schmidt trigger has two stable state simply means plus V saturation and minus V saturation. This is why it is also known as bistable circuit, because it has two stable states. It is also known as a square wave generator. Hysteresis is also found in this circuit. So hysteresis is same hysteresis which you have studied in measurement subject in your third semester. So if you want to summarize Schmidt trigger, so you can simply say, when output voltage changes with respect to the input, which means when input crosses a certain voltage levels, the upper threshold voltage, which is termed as VTU, and lower threshold voltage, which is termed as VTL. So this is the band. Whenever your input is crossing these two values, VTU and VTL, the output of the complete circuit will change. Okay, so you can have two types of Schmidt trigger. One is inverting and the other one is non-inverting. Here you have to focus mainly on the feedback. Inverting and non-inverting terminology will be same as in the negative feedback circuit, but here you should focus on, while drawing the circuit, you should focus on the feedback topology. Okay, so if you observe here in this circuit, this is inverting Schmidt trigger. Why this is inverting Schmidt trigger? Because you have connected a supply voltage V in to the inverting terminal, which is this. Okay, and if you draw parallel between the negative feedback circuit and positive feedback circuit, this output V naught is getting into the non-inverting terminal. Earlier it was always getting into the inverting terminal. Okay, so its working will change. It will not be same as it was in negative feedback, but the analysis of the basic circuit will remain same. By this I mean your output for this circuit will also be calculated using this standard equation, which says V naught is equals to A V plus. V plus means voltage on the non-inverting terminal, and minus V minus, voltage on the inverting terminal. Okay, so now suppose if you want to calculate V positive in terms of V naught, okay, so you will use the voltage divider equation. So voltage, according to voltage divider equation, V plus in terms of V naught will be V naught R1 opposite resistance divided by R1 plus R2. So this is V plus voltage in terms of V naught. So this is telling you your output, or the even the input has become function of your output voltage, which was not the case earlier. Do you follow? So now let's do the further analysis. So here you have to remember one thing. In this literature, they have addressed VH and VL. Okay, so this VH is nothing but your plus V saturation. Okay, similarly VL is your negative saturation voltage. Okay, so the key to analyze these positive feedback circuit is to assume an initial condition. So the possible values of V naught can take, VH means plus V saturation means output can go up to saturation voltage. Similarly, in negative direction, V naught can take minus saturation voltage. So also here, we'll assume that VL is less than zero, which I simply said when you treat VL as minus VSAT, VL as minus VSAT. So automatically you are telling here that VL is less than zero. This is your VL. So this is just to avoid confusion. Too much nomenclature should not confuse you. Okay, so let's go ahead. So here we have already calculated V plus in terms of V out. So here we are assuming when initially our V naught is VH, which means plus V sat. Okay. And the output is, so now you will put this V plus value in the INR standard equation, which was V naught is equals to A V plus minus V minus. So this was inverting type of configuration. So V plus value from here we have taken, and what was the applied voltage on inverting terminal? That was V in. So these two things have been replaced in this equation. So from here I request you to note down this particular equation on a rough page so that you can connect with this explanation. Okay, let us consider case one. Before jumping on to the case one, let's write the main equation, which is for the output, which is V naught is equals to A V plus minus V minus. So you have to remember this equation because this is the governing equation. Either you are operating with positive feedback or negative feedback. So here V plus is the potential which is coming from the output side, which means V plus is this, and V minus is the potential applied on the inverting terminal, which is V in. So when this V in, as long as V in is less than VH R1 upon R1 plus R2, which is on later stage is termed as V TU. So as long as V in is less than this VTU, your output will be stable at VH. I told you earlier also, VH is nothing but plus V saturation. Okay. So the moment your V input will cross this VTU voltage, VTU, you can also term it as threshold upper voltage. T stands for threshold, U stands for upper voltage. Okay, so the moment it will cross this V in becomes greater than this value, your output will change or transit to another state called VL. Okay, followed. So this is all about case one, when your V in is increasing and crossing this upper threshold voltage. So now let's see what happens when your V in starts decreasing. Okay, means your V in will move in this direction. Okay, so the moment your V in will decrease, it will again come across another threshold voltage, which is called lower threshold voltage. Lower threshold voltage will be VTL is equals to VL R1 upon R1 plus R2, where VL is nothing but minus V saturation. Okay. So, in order for a transition to happen, again, the term VL upon, so now here, your equation will change. Earlier it was VH upon R1 plus R2, now it will be VL upon R1 plus R2, where VL is nothing but minus V saturation. So this will become your equation. Now you are decreasing this V in the negative direction. So automatically sign has to change. This will happen when V in goes below. Then this VL upon R1 plus R2. Please understand, you have to clearly analyze the signs here. Here VL is a negative value. Okay, so V in has to be more negative as compared to this. If you just operate with variables here, you may confuse. So I would suggest you put VL and VH here as plus VSAT and minus VSAT, then you will be able to realize then when V in is becoming more negative as compared to this point, then this transition will happen. Okay, so this, if you combine these two, figure A and figure B, you will get this sort of a window. So this VTU, the upper threshold and the lower threshold difference, is called the noise immunity. Okay, so means if your input levels are within this range, okay, so your circuit will be immune to noise. Okay, this is your voltage characteristics of inverting Schmitt trigger. Now let's discuss non-inverting Schmitt trigger. Non-inverting Schmitt trigger, what are the changes you will make? Earlier, if you observe, we have kept V in here instead of this ground, but now we are making non-inverting, so we will put V input in on the non-inverting terminal and the remaining circuit will be as it is. Okay, so now again, first I request pause the video and draw this circuit on your copy so that you can derive these equations immediately. I hope that you have drawn the circuit. So let's analyze the circuit. In this circuit, the input is applied on the non-inverting terminal. Hence, this will become function of input voltage as well as output voltage. Now, the governing equation will remain same as V0 is equals to A, V plus minus V minus. V plus and V minus are the voltage applied on the op-amp terminal. Okay. So, in this case, what will happen? V plus we have calculated here by equation 1.10. But if you observe the circuit on the inverting terminal, you have applied a ground, which means your inverting terminal will be at zero potential, and by the virtual ground concept, you can tell V plus will be equal to V minus and hence it will be zero. So what we are doing, we are putting this V plus is equals to zero. Okay, so this R1 plus R2 is coming here and getting cancelled out. So here, this zero will be the crossing point. Whenever your V plus is crossing zero potential, the transition will happen. So V in, now termed as VT, or the transition potential, V naught as it is. So this equation is changed to now equation 1.1. So now let's assume if the initial state, means when you are beginning the analysis, your output voltage was VL. VL is nothing but minus V saturation. Okay, then VT value in terms of VL, VT is equals to minus R1 upon R2 VL. And since VL is less than zero, VL is less than zero because it is minus saturation voltage. Okay, VT will become positive. Okay, and this will become V, when VT is becoming positive, so this particular voltage will become upper threshold voltage. This corresponding part you will see later, the corresponding figure you will see later. Now the output, so what is the second condition? When your output is at VH, VH is nothing but plus V saturation. Okay. So now do the same analysis, replace this V naught with VH and then calculate the equation. So same thing will happen. Earlier when we started with VL, this will make the transition when your input will cross this upper threshold. Why this has become positive? Because your VL was negative and you had a negative sign in the expression. So similarly, for the other case, when we are starting with VH, this will be the figure. When you combine these two points, you will get the voltage characteristics like this. Again, this VTU minus VTL is the noise immunity. Now, there are other cases also where you can apply potentials on both the terminals here also, and you can connect a reference voltage here. So if you recall the analysis of comparator, the whole characteristic was shifted to a location. Same thing will happen with this window also here, the noise immunity window. Same thing will happen. It will shift to either side. So you can refer the PDF which I shared, but for better understanding, I would encourage you to go through the video attached in this video itself from gatepaper.in. So from example, you try to learn the Schmitt trigger operation. Thank you.
Whether the circuit is non-inverting amplifier, inverting amplifier, oscillator or Schmitt trigger, we should identify the correct answer. So before identifying this one, okay, we see if you are going with a basic amplifier. What we are going with is basic amplifier. Basic amplifier is nothing but where an amplifier with no feedback. So basic amplifier, the meaning is nothing but amplifier with no feedback. So generally we can introduce feedback to improve the characteristics of amplifier, but the feedback is of two types. Either the feedback can be positive feedback or the feedback can be negative feedback. So if you are going with a basic amplifier and you can apply negative feedback, so that characteristics of amplifier is going to be improved. So more ideal amplifier is going to be achieved. That is nothing but here the amplifier performance improved. Improved amplifier performance is nothing but more stability in gain. Okay, and input and output impedances are going to be modified according to the requirement, and bandwidth is going to be increases, noise is reduces. All are advantages of negative feedback, and negative feedback is always used in amplifiers. Okay, and whenever we are going with negative feedback, remember that one, this is always, okay, this negative feedback is nothing but there will be a beta network is going to be there. Beta network is always of resistive nature. Beta network is of resistive nature. Next, come for this one. If basic amplifier, if you are introducing positive feedback, in positive feedback, feedback implies nothing but you are taking a part of output and connecting it towards input side. Then whenever you are connecting through a sum network, that network is going to be called as beta network, and that beta network, if it is resistive, okay, at that time it acts as comparator. If that beta network is reactive, that is if it consisting of inductor, capacitor or combination of that one, at that time that will become reactive beta network. If the beta network is reactive, at that time it can act as oscillator. Okay, so this is positive feedback can be in this one. You can go in this way. If beta network is reactive, reactive implies nothing but either L or C or combination or both are going to be present at that time. It can act as oscillator. If beta network is resistive, if beta network is resistive, that is positive feedback with beta network resistive, by that time it can act as comparator and Schmitt trigger. It can act as comparator, Schmitt trigger, multivibrators. Okay, all these are going to be considered as positive feedback with beta network resistive. Okay, and in this one beta network reactive, that is oscillators, along with the condition is nothing but loop gain has to be equal to 1. Since loop gain is equal to 1, that we can generally rate it as A beta is equal to 1. And beta network is reactive, that's why we are going with two conditions. Since beta network is reactive, you can express this one. Loop gain is equal to 1 is nothing but simply you have to write in this way. 1 plus J0, because it is reactive network. From that one we are getting two conditions. One is Barkhausen's magnitude criteria, the other is Barkhausen phase criteria. Okay, so now look at this one. If an amplifier is having negative feedback, definitely that has to be a better amplifier only. So amplifier always uses negative feedback, whereas oscillators always uses positive feedback with reactive beta network. That is, the beta network should consist of either inductor or capacitor or combination of both. And third one is nothing but positive feedback with beta network resistive. So resistive beta network with positive feedback can act as comparators, Schmitt trigger, multivibrators, etc. Now observe the diagram. Feedback is nothing but a part of output that has to be connected towards input side. So look at this one. This is the output side and it is connecting towards input side. And input side, this is non-inverting op amp input. So this type of feedback is going to be called as positive feedback. So if you are taking a portion of output connecting towards non-inverting, at that time that will be treated as positive feedback, and if you are connecting output towards inverting input, at that time that is negative feedback. So this circuit is having positive feedback. So the op amp circuit given is having positive feedback, so it cannot be an amplifier. So non-inverting amplifier is wrong and inverting amplifier is also wrong out of the other two, oscillator and Schmitt trigger. So identify the feedback consisting of reactive elements or resistive elements. Since the feedback consisting of only R1, so R1 is a resistive, so the beta network is resistive with positive feedback, so it can act as Schmitt trigger. If it consisting of reactive elements, at that time there is a chance that it can act as oscillator if A beta is equal to 1. So there is no chance of acting this circuit as oscillator, as there is no reactive components. So the right option for this one is Schmitt trigger. Thank you. Look at the circuit diagram given with op amp. For the circuit shown in the figure, V0 is, what is the output voltage? V0, A minus 1 volt, B 2 volts, C plus 1 volt, D plus 15 volts. What will be the right answer? So first of all, try to identify the op amp operating in which mode, whether it is inverting mode or non-inverting mode. That is the basic thing what we will do generally. Okay, so from that one we can say that one here it is acting as, okay, and the feedback is connected. You may be thinking that one it may be in the non-inverting mode. Remember that it is not either non-inverting or inverting mode. Okay, so generally you have to check, first of all, whenever you are going to given any op amp circuit, first of all the first step what you have to identify is nothing but whether the feedback is positive feedback or negative feedback. So you have to check output is going to be feeding back to inverting terminal or non-inverting terminal. If the output is connected to, if the V0 is connected back to, if the V0 is connected to that is if the output is connected to inverting terminal, inverting input, then it is negative feedback. So if the output is connected to inverting input, by that time the feedback is known as negative feedback. And otherwise, if the output is connected to non-inverting input, then the feedback is called as positive feedback. Okay, so there are two types of feedback can exist in op-amp because there are two inputs. One is inverting input, the other is non-inverting input. For any given circuit, first thing is nothing but you must check what is the type of feedback signal. What is the type of feedback employed? Here it is. The given circuit is employed with positive feedback. But remember that only negative feedback is going to be used for the amplifiers. So if the op-amp is having negative feedback, then only there are three different cases are going to be existing. One is inverting op-amp. The other is non-inverting mode op-amp. So op-amp, that is operational amplifier, can act as amplifier either in inverting mode or non-inverting mode or differential mode only when the feedback is negative. So by that time the gain is, if you are going with gain, is for this inverting op-amp gain is RF by R1, for non-inverting op-amp gain is 1 plus RF by R1, and for differential mode also the gain is minus RF by R1. So this is going to be the gain provided for the amplifiers whenever the feedback is negative. But remember, whenever the feedback is positive, whenever the feedback is positive, only one application, always it act as comparator. Always it act as comparator. And whenever it is acting as comparator, the output may be at either plus VCC or minus VCC. Plus or minus VCC. In our case, it may be at plus 15 or minus 15. So when it will be in plus 15, when it will be at minus 15. For that one, V0 is equal to plus VCC if voltage at non-inverting terminal is greater than voltage at inverting terminal. That is, if the voltage at non-inverting terminal is dominating over inverting terminal voltage, by the time output will be at plus VCC. Otherwise, V0 will be at minus VCC if the voltage at inverting terminal dominates over voltage at non-inverting terminal. So first step, we have to check about the feedback. From the feedback we can assume that when it is acting as comparator, and then you have to check about which terminal is dominating, voltage at which terminal it is dominating. So now inverting terminal is connecting with ground, that is 0 volts, whereas non-inverting terminal is connecting with plus 1. So plus 1 is more than 0 volts, so output will be at plus 15 volts. So the right answer for this question is D. If in the question, okay, we will modify this question. If it is given as, instead of plus 1, if it is given as minus 1 volt, then what will be the answer? If it is given as minus 1 volt, then the output will be at minus 15. Minus 15 volts, because 0 is greater than minus 1, so inverting terminal dominates, so that the output voltage is at minus 15 volts. Okay, so for this question the right answer is D, 15 volts plus.